Hi, how are you going? I hope you're feeling as well as possible on your medicines. I'm Pharmacist Fi. Welcome to my YouTube channel and to this episode of Some Need to Know Info about a new medicine with the brand name Paxlovid, which is an antiviral medicine to help fight COVID-19 infection. In this video, I'll be giving you 10 top tips about how you and your doctor together can figure out if Paxlovid may be suitable for you or not, and if it is suitable, how to try to avoid risky medicine interactions between Paxlovid and some other medicines, herbal products, supplements, foods and drinks. Firstly, please keep in mind that this video does not cover everything you need to know about Paxlovid. Also, please note that because Paxlovid is such a new medicine, as new research comes out in the coming months or years, compared to what I'm putting into this video, there might be changes in how Paxlovid is taken or how Paxlovid's medicine interactions need to be managed by doctors. So if anyone prescribes Paxlovid for you, make sure you ask your pharmacist for the latest advice and a copy of the latest Paxlovid CMI at that time. And in case you're wondering, CMI stands for Consumer Medicine Information. And I'll put a link to a video about CMIs into the description section below this video for you. Top tip number one. Paxlovid should not be taken if you have severe liver or kidney problems, galactose intolerance, total lactase deficiency, or glucose-galactose malabsorption. And the manufacturer also advises against taking it if you are pregnant or breastfeeding. So together with your doctor, figure out if any of these situations apply to you. Paxlovid medicine interactions can vary from mild to potentially lethal, depending on which product is interacting with it. So if you don't already have a current list of your medicines, top tip number two is to make a medicines, allergies, and contacts list and put everything you take onto it and how you take each of those things. And give a copy to your doctor and pharmacist and ask them to please use your list to run an interactions check of everything you take versus Paxlovid to help decide whether Paxlovid may be suitable for you or not. And also, remember to put anything you take from the supermarket, pharmacy, or health food store onto your list, even including vitamin and mineral products, supplements, and herbal medicines, as well as medicines prescribed by doctors. And foods or drinks with grapefruit in them. And I'll put a link to my video about making a medicines, allergies, and contacts list into the description section below this video for you. And if possible, I recommend you make your list with help from your doctor and pharmacist before you get COVID-19, because everything is easier to do when you're not unwell. Top tip number three. If you want to start any new medicines, vitamin and mineral products, supplements, or herbal products during treatment with Paxlovid or the first 3 days after stopping Paxlovid, ask your pharmacist or doctor to please check for possible interactions first to check if any of those things may be safe for you to take or not. Top tip number four. Some medicines may only need changes on the days that you take Paxlovid, but some other medicines may also need changes continued for 3 days after stopping Paxlovid or for 4 weeks after stopping Paxlovid, depending on what medicine it is. Top tip number five. If any medicine changes are needed for medicines that you usually take because they interact with Paxlovid, ask your doctor exactly how to make the changes as safely as possible for each of those medicines, and what dates and times of day should be when the first change and the last change happens for each medicine. And write these changes and dates onto your medicines, allergies, and contacts list while the doctor is telling you about them, so that you can then regularly check your list before you take your medicines to try to take them the best way possible. Top tip number six. If you don't read or write, ask your doctor if you could please record them telling you the medicine changes, dates, medicine names, and what each medicine looks like onto a recording device such as your mobile phone, so that you can regularly listen back to that before you take your medicines to try to take them the best way possible. Top tip number seven. If any of your medicines are in the category of a mild interaction with Paxlovid, so that medicine changes are not needed initially, but you do need to report side effects to your doctor immediately if you get any, ask your doctor the names of your interacting medicines and circle them on your medicines, allergies and contacts list so you know which medicines you especially need to find out side effects for, which we'll talk about in the next top tip. Top tip number 8, get a CMI for each medicine you take and keep them near your medicines so they're easy to find. And read the section about side effects to find out possible side effects and what to do about them if they happen for each of your medicines. Now, why would I suggest this? Well, knowing how to find out about side effects quickly is especially important if any of your medicines interact with Paxlovid, because if the interaction increases the amount of medicine in your body, it may increase the main effect and the side effects of that medicine. And while some side effects are just mild and unpleasant, some side effects of some medicines may be life-threatening and need urgent treatment. So getting CMIs and keeping them somewhere easy to find is brilliant for medicine safety when you take any medicines, not just Paxlovid. And speaking of Paxlovid, let's take a quick look at its possible side effects. Top tip number 9. The most common side effects in the main clinical trial were a change in the sense of taste in your mouth, which happened to about 5.6 people per 100 people taking Paxlovid. And the other side effects happened to less than 2 people per 100 people taking Paxlovid. And these were diarrhea, vomiting, myalgia, which is aching, tender or weak muscles not due to exercise, hypertension, which is high blood pressure, and headache. Since the main clinical trial was conducted, there've also been some reports of other similar side effects, such as nausea, which is feeling like you might vomit, or abdominal pain, or generally feeling unwell. Like a lot of other medicines, Paxlovid does have a few really serious and potentially life-threatening, uncommon or rare side effects to watch out for, such as severe allergic reactions. And this may include anything from rash, itch, hives, swelling of the face, tongue, lips, eyes or throat, a hoarse voice, finding it hard to breathe, feeling breathless, lightheaded or dizzy, getting low blood pressure, feeling unwell generally, diarrhea, feeling nauseous or vomiting. Another uncommon but serious risk is liver problems, and this may include symptoms such as loss of appetite, nausea or vomiting, pale fatty bowel motions of poos or poops, brown urine instead of the usual yellow or clear, and abdominal pain or discomfort in the right upper abdomen just below your ribcage. So make sure you read your Paxlovid CMI to find out what to do if you do get any side effects, like whether to call an ambulance, get taken to the nearest hospital emergency department immediately, or whether to call your doctor immediately, depending on what the symptoms are. Top tip number 10. If you're a woman taking a combined contraceptive pill or using a combined hormonal device to prevent pregnancy with ethinyl estradiol in them, a medicine interaction with Paxlovid may increase risk of getting pregnant. So ask your doctor whether or not you might need to use an additional barrier method, such as condoms, or a different form of contraception during Paxlovid treatment and also for 1 month after stopping Paxlovid. I'll be making a video especially focused on Paxlovid interactions in the next month. Then we'll also have a quick look at how to take Paxlovid, because Paxlovid needs to be taken a very particular way to work well. So please check back to this site soon. Please click the subscribe and like buttons below if you'd like to see more of these medicine safety videos. And if you have any questions about anything I've chatted about in this video, please leave a comment below this video and I will get back to you as soon as possible. Denver and I look forward to catching up with you again very soon here on this Pharmacist Fi Medicine Safety YouTube channel. Thanks for watching. Bye.